Hi everyone, let's do a 360 spin to start the video. Okay, now let's get serious. Today I want to show you some advanced tactical motifs in chess. If you're a beginner, some of these may seem difficult, but I think you should still watch, because it's always interesting to see what comes next, what the next level entails, to whet the appetite as they say. And buckle up, because we're going to be going fast. You may need to re-watch the video a few times if you miss something. This first one is about undefended pieces, which could be considered the simplest tactical motif. But this is just to warm up and also show that even the simple motif may include various other motifs or themes. So here it's black to move. You're free to pause the video if you want to try and find the best move. The solution is knight f4, which is sort of like a fork or double attack. We're attacking the queen and a fork on d3. I should have mentioned the undefended piece in this case is the bishop on d2, because this is obviously a sacrifice. They take our knight. But then we take on d4 with the queen, double attack as well, picking up the undefended piece, and we've won a pawn in the process, this pawn on d4. And the white king will be exposed, quite exposed, so black's completely winning. And if they block, obviously we take with the rook. And okay, moving on. This one is more complicated. Zwischenzug, which is German, or in-between move. Not sure if it's correct translation, but it's what we use in chess. So white to move. So the solution is queen g4, sort of like a double attack. But you may think, doesn't their queen also attack our queen? Yes, but after queen takes g4 from black, we throw in a move. Instead of recapturing, which is the normal move, we throw in a check on e8. Rook takes e8, check. After king moves, then we recapture. And we're up a rook because we traded queens, but we won this rook. So check, they take, and now instead of recapturing, we throw in this in-between move, then we recapture, two rooks against one, pretty good. Okay, overworked piece, this is quite tricky, white to move. You should notice that this check would win the queen if it wasn't defended, if the black queen wasn't defended, because we'd be discovering an attack from our queen on their queen. But it's defended by this bishop. But what that means is this bishop is overworked. It's doing too many jobs because it's also defending this knight. So we simply take the knight. And the bishop can't recapture because if it does, goodbye queen, check, and attacking the queen. So if they take our bishop, we win the queen. So back here, black couldn't take this rook, meaning we just took a knight for free because this bishop is overworked. Number four, also quite advanced and complicated, is interference. Here it's white to move. Hopefully you note that we could take this rook, except this pawn is pinned by the black queen and we'd lose our queen. So what we do is interfere with the queen's alignment with our queen by playing rook b3. Now we are threatening to take their rook, right? And we're threatening their queen. And you may think, what about bishop takes rook? Because then after we take their rook, it's rook for rook. However, then our queen is pinning their bishop to their queen. So instead of the pin being on our pawn, we're now pinning their bishop and we'll win it. So rook b3, very nice. If bishop takes, we take. And now we're going to win the bishop because it's pinned and attacked twice. Number five, trapped piece, which is a bit simpler, but we're often not on the lookout. Like we should be, every single move, looking for every type of motif, including this one, trapped piece, white to move. Should be quite obvious that this bishop is very misplaced and it doesn't have many squares. So the solution is rook a1 attacking the bishop. Sorry if you can hear the people shouting outside. Bishop has two options, right? b3 or e6. If e6, we play d5 and it's trapped already. And if b3, then we play rook a3, forcing bishop e6, and then we trap it. Also note that these two squares are controlled, so can't go here or here. Has to go here, and d5. Can't go here, sorry, because of our pawn. This is a second puzzle about a trapped piece, black to move. This came from a game of mine, just to show you that it is important to always see to consider. Or to look for these motifs, because here you could play a normal move like rook here, and that would give white the chance to defend and not lose a piece, but they do lose a piece after f5, attacking this bishop. The bishop moves all the way back. Then f4 traps this bishop. It's got nowhere to go, and our pawn's defended twice, so they lose the bishop. Okay, second last one is double check. This is also quite simple, but often we underestimate the power of a double check. So it's white to move. We play this very nice sacrifice. Queen takes h7 check, forcing king takes only move, and then rook e7 double check with the rook and the bishop. And that means that the king has to move. You can't block or take a double check because there's two pieces giving check. And after king h8, the only legal move, rook h7 is checkmate. So very nice queen sacrifice and double check. Again, showing the power of a double check. Black's only legal move here is king h8, and then rook h7, checkmate. And lastly, attraction. This is where we attract a piece to a certain square to our benefit or advantage. So here, black to move. The solution is rook takes d4. If they don't recapture with the c-pawn, we're up a lot of material. If they do recapture, we only win if we play rook c2, which also pins the queen to the king. But if it looks like a free rook, if queen takes rook, we have knight e3, fork, because we've attracted the queen to c2, meaning the fork works. And if they don't take the rook, then we just take the queen. So rook takes, pawn takes, rook c2, very nice attraction, setting up this fork. And we're just up a knight. So that's all. Hopefully, well, let me know in the comments if you already knew all of these motifs or some of them. And also let me know if you want to see more videos like this. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss them. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.